Cloud Platform Enthusiast, I'm Tiyani. And today, I'm going to show you something super exciting. The brand new Git integration in Power Platform. This game-changing feature takes away the hassles of managing your solution and artifacts in source control. No more complex Git setups. It's literally a click away. I'll guide you through every step, from enabling Git integration in the Power Platform admin portal to seamlessly using it with your solution in the Maker portal. So stick around till the end. Before we jump in, hit that subscribe button, smash the thumbs up button, and share your thoughts in the comment section down below. Your support helps keep this content coming. All right, let's jump into the Maker portal. Head over to Solutions. On the toolbar, click on Ellipsis next to History. Notice there's just one item, Switch to Classic. That means Git integration hasn't been enabled for this environment yet. To enable it, click on Power Platform and click on the Admin Center tile. Here's the Admin Center. This is where we enable the Git integration feature. Let's give it a moment to load. Okay, we are in. Select the environment you want to configure. Since this feature is still in preview, I'll create a new environment. Click New. Give your environment a name. Let's call this one T365 Dev. And toggle Get New Features Early to On. This ensures the feature is available in this environment. Note that Git integration is currently in preview, meaning that there's only selected few regions that are enabled for it. For example, I can choose Canada or United States. Select the environment type to developer, click Next, and configure any additional settings like currency or sample data. Then click on Save. Your environment will begin to process. Once it's done, make sure the release cycle is set to early for access to preview features. Next, let's head over to Azure DevOps. Here we'll create a new project. Click New Project. Give it a name. How about Git Integration Power Platform Dev? Set the visibility to private or public. Ensure the version control is set to Git. Then hit that create button. With the project created, go to repository and click on initialize to create a new repository. This will set up your repository with just the basic README file. Back in the Maker portal, switch to the new environment we just created earlier. Go to Solutions on the sitemap. And now you'll see Connect to Git option in the toolbar. Click on it to start the setup. In the side pane, choose environment as the connection type. This ensures all the solutions in that environment will be in source control. Select your Azure DevOps organization, the project we just created, and the repository. Don't forget to choose the correct branch. Right now, we only have the main branch in Azure DevOps. Let's create additional branches, Dev and QA. Branches are ready. Back in Power Platform, let's finish the setup. Select the Dev branch and create a folder. I will call mine dev_folder, then click Connect. A green notification confirms the setup is successful. If you click View Source Control, it takes us back to Azure DevOps, where you'll see the new folder created from Power Platform. Let's put this integration to use. Create a new solution in Power Platform. Set the display name, Git Demo. Create a publisher if needed. Once saved, check out New Source Control tab in your sitemap for your solution. This tab shows your solution branches, changes, updates, and conflicts. You can even commit changes directly without switching to VS Code or the Git terminal. Add a comment, click on commit. A notification will confirm your commit status. Now go to Azure DevOps. You'll see the updated commit message, including folders for your entities and changes. Let's resolve the conflict scenarios. Add tables like account and contact to your solution. Let's include columns, views, and forms, and click on the Add button. You'll notice changes and potential conflicts. Click Accept incoming changes. Then commit your modifications with a comment. Back in Azure DevOps, check the history to see all the commits you've made. And that's how you enable and use the Git integration feature in Power Platform. It's a streamlined way to manage source control with Azure DevOps directly from Power Platform. If you've enjoyed this in-depth walk, give us a like, share your thoughts in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.